The Project Lofty team had one shot to capture the total solar eclipse of 2017. Since the team was geographically separated, we used computer-aided design, otherwise known as CAD, software, as a communication tool to share ideas and design the rig. Any models created could be manufactured using the CNC mill or 3D printers. I was able to import models of known items like the GoPros and some commercially available battery packs while we were designing the custom 360 camera assembly. Most 360 camera rigs are compact, but ours needed to fit the extra batteries and possibly a stability system. I tested the field of view of each of the cameras and then arranged them to make sure that we had consistent coverage in the full 360 sphere. The cameras had to form a cube. The rig needed to be light, which meant most of it would be open space. I was inspired by the RC telescopes, and I chose to use carbon fiber rods as the attachment between the faceplates because they were light and strong. The faceplates needed to mount the camera to the rest of the rig. Originally, I was going to machine them out of aluminum. This would have been a way to act as a heat sink while also being a structural member. However, it was still just not light enough to be flight worthy. Instead, I chose to work with a 3D printed material that I knew would withstand the temperature ranges the rig would encounter during its flight. The rods had to be at the corners so we could access the camera's door. We used a GoPro frame mount as the attachment method. This was a tight fit for the screw, but it just worked. To continue to save weight, I carved out some of the faceplate. Holes were added in case we needed to attach anything later, and this came in handy, especially when we needed to mount the fan for the heat sinks. We chose to use a regular heat sink attached to the back of the GoPro because without the aluminum faceplate, we needed an alternative method for heat dissipation. The inside of the rig housed the battery packs, and for a while, it also doubled as space for the CAD stability system. Once all the parts of the stability system were added, it was far too heavy, and there were no other areas we could cut weight. I was able to quickly shrink down the model after CAD was removed. The carbon fiber tubes were going to be attached with Loctite, which meant that it was going to be very tight if we had to reach in and change something on the inside. So we decided to take some of the corner pieces and split them, and then make that side of the rig removable. The second major design was the marionette system. This was a passive stability system for the GoPro rig that dampened the rotation. It consisted of two carbon fiber rods joined by a 3D printed part. The ends of the rod had printed 3D parts as well, and they routed the paracord between the individual payloads. The payload package above the GoPro rig was a Garmin Verb camera. It was a last minute addition. The only thing we had time to design in CAD was the marionette mounting part. This would help limit the spinning and provide an attachment point for the rest of the payload train. The rest of the Verb rig was built using a whiteboard design. We took some awl thread and some pieces of wooden plywood, and we made a mount that we attached to the plastic printed part. Above the Verb was a tracking system. It was a hollow styrofoam sphere that encompassed another marionette system. Most people stick their payload in a styrofoam cooler to keep it warm. We wanted the warmth, but we also needed something with structural integrity to hold the weight of the expensive camera equipment below. The heart of the tracking system rig was the platform on the marionette. The platform was designed to house the custom APRS tracking system and the battery pack, as well as the Spot GPS satellite tracker. The foam sphere also held the antenna, and it would float, at least temporarily, if we had a water landing. CAD allowed us to try different designs, know when we hit our weight limit, see if parts would fit, quickly print and prototype, and let all the group members visualize the payloads and work out any issues prior to flight. And in doing so, we were able to effectively build this project while all living in different states and working in our spare time. And when it came to the assemble, everything fit together perfectly, and it flew, and we couldn't ask for better results given how we lost our first balloon. Thanks for watching this Behind the Design episode of SciJoy. If you have any questions or comments, please feel free to leave them below. And remember, keep exploring.